Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston. Welcome and thank you for joining us for today's edition of ISS Update. This Wednesday, October 3rd, the Expedition 33 crew members had began their day with some time this morning for work preparation, breakfast, morning hygiene, and a station inspection. The crew then kicked off their day with the first of two daily planning conferences with ground controllers around the world to review the day's activities and plan for the next set of tasks. Today, Commander Williams is busy performing maintenance on the potable water dispenser beverage adapter, replacing the activated carbon ion exchange filter in the oxygen generator system. Williams will also, in just a few minutes, participate in a private medical conference today. These periodic private medical conferences are set with long-duration crew members with their flight surgeons to discuss their medical and health status, human factors, and habitation systems. And just minutes ago, Williams took time out to talk with Dr. Sanjay Gupta with CNN and Kenneth Cheng of New York Times during an in-flight event. Commander Williams, as a crew medical officer, also had assisted flight engineer Aki Hoshide in the U.S. laboratory with an integrated cardiovascular monitoring session. The goal of the integrated cardiovascular experiment is to quantify the extent, time course, and clinical significance of cardiac atrophy and identify its mechanisms. This experiment consists of two separate but related activities over a one-week period time, an ultrasound echo scan, and in today's activity, an ambulatory monitoring session. Hoshide also had conducted microbial air sampling inside the Japanese experiment module. He then worked to remove and replace the pre-treat tank of the waste and hygiene compartment and performed a fluid transfer from the water recovery system that produces drinkable water for the crew. Hoshide also pre-packed items that will be returned to Earth aboard the Dragon spacecraft, slated to arrive at the station later this month. And on the Russian side of the house, Malenchenko had spent some time cleaning vents and performing a regular preventative maintenance to the service module's ventilation system and regular maintenance to the Russian life support system known as SOJ. Each of the crew members will then put in their daily 2 hours of exercise using the onboard gym equipment that includes a station bicycle, a treadmill, and an advanced resistive exercise device that simulates weightlifting here on Earth. The crew will then wrap the day with a final daily planning conference with the ground. The crew is then scheduled to go to bed at 4:30 p.m. Central Time. Meanwhile, late last night, the automated transfer vehicle 3, also known as Eduardo Amaldi, that had undocked from the International Space Station last Friday, had performed two final burns that sent the spacecraft on a re-entry trajectory over the Pacific Ocean. And that's a recap of today's activities aboard the International Space Station. This is Mission Control Houston.